Hello friends, good morning. I hope you all are safe. Here, I am inviting you to all of you on our YouTube channel, Sri Swaminarayan Physiotherapy College, Rani. Myself, Dr. Jimisha Panchal, and today I want to share with you about the upper cross syndrome. But before I begin, do not forget to like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel for new upcoming updates. The reason why we get such type of syndrome is because of poor posture. It altered the mechanism of the muscles, ligament and lastly bones. It leads to neck pain, headache, back pain, hip, knee, ankle, all are getting pain, and also acid reflux, that is discomfort in upper chest. So now we'll see what is upper cross syndrome. It is mainly occur due to muscles of the neck, shoulder and chest become deformed. As you can see in the screen, the weakness of neck flexors and tightness of extensors are seen. As we have already seen the cause previously, but these are some poor postures that can lead to upper cross syndrome. The first one is hunched posture. We can also say the forward head posture, and also using extra mobile phone in this posture that leads to your neck stiffness. So upper cross syndrome occurs due to continuous altered posture in daily routine life, like car and bike driving, watching TV, and also incorrect reading positions. Now we'll see the clinical features. It mainly seen that increase cervical lordosis and increase thoracic kyphosis. Then at the shoulder joint, you will see the elevation, protraction and the rounded shoulder. You can also see the winging of scapula. There are some relative symptoms you may see like headache, neck pain, chest pain or chest tightness, then pain in jaw. Patient may also feel tiredness, then problem in sitting and watching TV, then restricted active range of motion of shoulder joint and neck. Then if patient is getting chronic pain, then it leads to numbness and tingling sensation in the arms. Then lastly, it also goes to the lower back too. Through the normal changes in our daily routine life, we can prevent the upper cross syndrome. As you can see in the first photograph, the correction and incorrect position are given. So you have to correct your standing, sitting and walking position. Then do correction at your workplace and driving position. Then after, in your daily living activity, you have to add 30 minutes of walking or swimming, or you can add stretching exercise. If at your job place you have to sitting longer period of time, then you have to put a roll under your lower back and correct your sitting position. So here you can see the correct sleeping position on pillow. Take a look and change the incorrect one. Now we will go on our main part, that is treatment part. We can do that in three ways. The first one is correction of posture. As we discussed previously, that how we correct our posture in our daily routine life. The second one is stretching exercise, that is for reduce the tightness of muscles. The lastly, the strengthening exercise, that is for maintain the strength of the muscles. So to correct your posture, make your neck and shoulder in aligned position and reduce the tension at the upper back. First we will see the traction. In that, you have to lie down with a rolled towel under your neck. It creates the traction force to the cervical spine and distribute the tension. This position gives relaxation to the upper back. The second one is the form rolling. As you can see in the video, you have to lie down on form and you have to roll on the form. That will reduce the stiffness on your back. To reduce the stiffness in the neck, we have to do the active movements of the neck. As you can see in the video, there are different movements of the neck, that is flexion, extension, side flexion and side rotation. Do this exercise for each side for 10 to 15 times. In the shoulder joint, you have to do two movements. First one is you have to move your shoulder to the upward direction, that is shoulder shrugging movement. The second one is external rotation of the shoulder joint. Here in the external rotation, she is also using resisted band for progression. Then to correct the rounded shoulder, move your shoulder to the backward side, that is scapular retraction. This exercise will keep activated and strengthen the cervical flexors. It also stretch the scalene muscles. In that, you have to do align your chin to the parallel to the floor and pull your head backward direction. Hold this retracted position for 10 to 15 seconds. Then do it for 5 times. Stretching exercise gives you more benefit here. First, we will go for doorway stretch, that is pectoral stretch. Take this position like in the first video. Then step through door slowly until you feel a stretch at your upper chest. Hold this position for 30 seconds and repeat it for 3 times. The second one is the stretching of upper trapezius. Take the suitable position and grasp over the top of your head and apply mild force to the opposite side. Hold this position for 30 seconds and repeat it both the side for 3 times. The next one is half cobra pose. Here you will also feel the stretch at upper chest. In that, you have to lie down in prone and take the support of elbow. Then slowly prop yourself like in this first video and hold this position for 30 seconds and do it for 3 times. Then in the other one, that is shoulder opener, it will stretch the muscle which is surrounded by shoulder joint. You can do this stretching in the maintenance phase but under the supervision. Now we will move forward and see the strengthening exercise that maintain the strength of shoulder and neck muscles. First, we will see wall slide for upper and lower trapezius. In that, you have to stand with your back to the wall and try to keep your upper back and buttock in contact with the wall and feet apart. Then bend your elbow to the 90 degree and hand pointing towards your head. Try to press your forearm against the wall. Slowly slide your arms up toward your head, then back down. Begin with the 10 repetition, then increase the repetition. The second wall slide is for serratus anterior. In that, you have to stand in the front of the wall with theraband. You can see in the video and slide your both the hands and repeat this for 10 to 15 times. Here is the scapular strengthening exercise with theraband. As you can see in all the three videos, it gives strengthening to the scapular muscles. You can use the theraband according to the muscle power of your upper back. Now, lastly, but most importantly, the Blackburn exercise. We can also call it horizontal abduction in prone. It will increase the strength and endurance of shoulder and scapular muscle. You can do it first in prone position, Then in the later stage, to challenge the exercise, you can do it on the ball. You can do abduction in Y shape and T shape. Hold this position for 5 to 10 seconds and repeat it for 10 times. Be safe, be healthy, and keep doing exercise. Thank you so much, all of you.